Hello my dear students, today once again I am here in front of you with the second part of the chapter A Visit to Kaziranga and Sivasagar. In our last class we discussed how they reached Kaziranga and there they were staying in a hotel and it was their plan that the next day they will go to see the Kaziranga National Park. Now, in today's class, we are going to start now. Do you know Kaziranga is a World Heritage Site? The UNESCO declared Kaziranga a World Heritage Site in 1985, their father said. Now their father said, that means father of Lohit and Trisha said, means asked them, do you know Kaziranga National Park is a World Heritage Site? Now what is World Heritage Site? We'll get it later. The UNESCO declared Kaziranga a World Heritage Site in 1985 and he added, the UNESCO declared Kaziranga a World Heritage Site when? In 1985. Who said this? Father of Trisha and Lohit said. What did he say? He said Kaziranga is a World Heritage Site, and when it was declared as World Heritage Site, it was declared as World Heritage Site in 1985 by which organization? By the UNESCO. Meaning, asked Lohit. Now, meaning, Lohit asked, meaning means when his father said it is a World Heritage Site, he didn't understand anything. Now he's asking, what is the meaning of World Heritage Site? Meaning, he explained, a place is listed by the UNESCO as of special significance. Meaning. Now once again his father is saying, meaning means yes, I'm telling you the meaning. He started explaining what is the meaning of World Heritage Site. World Heritage Site is a place that is listed by the UNESCO as of special significance. That means World Heritage Site will be those sites or those places, those are listed by the UNESCO, an international organization, listed by that particular organization. Why? Of special significance. That means this particular site or this particular area or this particular place has some special significance. That's why the UNESCO declared this place as World Heritage Site. That means a site which is listed by an international organization, that is the UNESCO. Why? For its special significance. These sites are known as World Heritage Site. The UNESCO feels the need to preserve such sites in the interest of the international community. Why did UNESCO declare Kaziranga as World Heritage Site? Because the UNESCO feels the necessity to preserve such places, okay, to protect such places. Why? For the interest of international community, not only for Assam, not only for India, for whole international community, these kind of sites or these kind of places are to be preserved. That's why UNESCO preserved it and declared it as a World Heritage Site. Now, the next question Lohit is asking. He is a small guy, so he is very curious about everything. Now he is asking, what is the full form of UNESCO? Earlier he asked, meaning of World Heritage Site. He understood, his father explained what is World Heritage Site. Now he is asking, the organization which had declared Kaziranga as a World Heritage Site, what is the full form of that organization? In short, it was said that UNESCO, it was said by his father that UNESCO declared Kaziranga as World Heritage Site. Now he wants to know what is the full form of UNESCO. I knew it, but forgot, Trisha said. It is United Nations. Trisha said, it was known to me. It was known to me, but I forgot now. Okay, I learned it in my school, in my book. I learned it. What is the full form of UNESCO? But now I forgot. It happens to everyone. We learn. And after getting this, we think that, yes, I got it, but I forgot. It happened with Trisha also. She said, it was known to me, but now I forgot. But I am sure. It starts with what? United Nations. U, United, N, Nations. The remaining part, she forgot. That's why she said, I am sure. It is United Nations. But what is after that? It is forgotten by her. United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization, Mother Putin. So, mother interfered in the discussion and she said the full form of UNESCO. Mother of Trisha and Lohit, she interfered in the discussion of Trisha, Lohit and their father. And when Lohit asked the full form of UNESCO, Trisha said it was known to her, but she forgot. But she was sure that it starts with United Nations. After listening to that, their mother interfered in their discussion and she said the full form of UNESCO. What is the full form of UNESCO? United, U, United, N, Nations, E, Educational, S, Scientific, and C, Cultural, O, Organization. United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization. Okay, this is an international organization. It looks after education, it looks after scientific development, scientific activities, scientific works and cultural activities of whole world. How old is this Park Ma? After listening to her mother's reply of the question, what is the full form of UNESCO? He heard that. He came to know that the full form of UNESCO is what? United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization. After listening to that, his next question is, he's asking his mother, how old is this Park Ma? Now he's asking his mother that, what is the age of this Park Ma? How old is this Park Ma? He's asking his mom, he's asking his ma, and asking her what? Asking her about the age of the National Park, Kaziranga National Park. Actually, the history of Kaziranga as a protected area can be traced back to 1904. There is a long story behind it. Then she replied, actually, if we think about that, the history of Kaziranga as a protected area can be traced back in 1904. That means to know about the age of this Kaziranga National Park, we have to go back to 1904. There is a long story behind it. Okay, it was a forest, but when did it become a national park? If we want to know this, then we have to go to 1904, and then she said there is a long story behind it. Okay, if we go to 1904, then we can trace what is the matter. But while tracing, no, we will find a long story behind it. Tell us the story, ma, said Trisha. And Trisha also became curious. Okay, she is now insisting her mother to tell the story behind the Kaziranga National Park, who was always curious to know about places. Trisha, she asked her mom to tell the story, and Trisha was always curious. That means very eager to know about new places. When her mother said, we have to go to 1904, go back to 1904 to get the story of Kaziranga National Park, and if we go back to 1904, we'll get a long story. Listening to that note, Trisha became so much curious, and always she becomes curious whenever it is a matter of a place. Okay, so she is insisting her mother to tell the story. Well, now her mother started. Well, let's discuss. Okay, well, wait, I'm telling you. That means her mother started telling. In 1904, Mary Curzon visited Kaziranga. She was the wife of Lord Curzon, the then Viceroy of India. The then Viceroy of India, that means the then the Governor General of that period, was whom? Lord Curzon. And his wife was who? Mary Curzon. In 1904, Mary Curzon, the wife of Lord Curzon. Who was Lord Curzon? Viceroy of India. That means he was the Viceroy of India of that period. He was the Governor General of India of that period. His wife, Mary Curzon, visited Kaziranga National Park. She visited Kaziranga Forest in 1904. She had heard that Kaziranga was famous for rhinos. Before visiting the place, she came to know that this particular forest, Kaziranga, is famous for what? Rhinos. Okay? And she was eager to see rhinos, that's why she visited Kaziranga. But she could not find a single rhino there. But while visiting Kaziranga, she did not find a single rhino there in Kaziranga. She requested her husband to take measures immediately to protect the rhinos. Okay? Before going there, she heard that Kaziranga forest is famous for what? Rhinos. But while her visit, during her visit, she did not find a single rhino. Returning from the visit, okay, she requested her husband to protect rhinos immediately. That means to take steps, to take immediate steps to protect rhinos. She was afraid of the situation that rhinos may extinct. That's why she requested her husband to take necessary steps. Okay? Why? To protect rhinos. Soon after, in 1905, the Kaziranga proposed reserved forest was created. So after getting request from his wife, Lord Curzon proposed Kaziranga as a reserved forest in 1905. Okay? He sent the proposal to the British government, proposing that Kaziranga forest should be considered as a reserve forest. Reserve forest means what? That means it will be under the necessary caretaking of government. So in 1905, he sent the proposal to the British government. Who sent the proposal? The then Viceroy of India, Lord Curzon. He sent the proposal to the British government to consider Kaziranga as a reserve forest. Slowly, the park grew in size. So when it was proposed to become a reserve forest, gradually what happened? The size of Kaziranga proposed reserve forest started expanding. In 1916, it was named Kaziranga Game Sanctuary. And in 1916, the Kaziranga was named as Kaziranga Game Sanctuary. Okay, Kaziranga Game Sanctuary. In 1904, Mary Curzon visited Kaziranga. Then she requested her husband to take necessary steps to protect rhinos. Then in 1905, after getting the request, what he did? He sent the proposal to the British government to make it a reserve forest. And after becoming a reserve forest, the area of Kaziranga reserve forest started increasing, started expanding. And in 1916, it has got a new name. What was the name? Kaziranga Game Sanctuary. Visitors were allowed to enter the park. Hunting was strictly prohibited. So in 1916, it became what? Kaziranga Game Sanctuary, and visitors were allowed to enter into the park, but hunting inside the park was strictly prohibited. Hunting means killing of animals. That means at that time people used to hunt for amusement. Okay? So hunting was strictly prohibited at that time. Where? In Kaziranga Game Sanctuary. Then in 1950, the name was again changed. So in 1916, new name was given to Kaziranga Reserve Forest. It became what? Kaziranga Game Sanctuary. And in 1950, once again, the name of Kaziranga Game Sanctuary was changed. Why? Didn't they like the name? Asked Lohit. And Lohit asked, why? Didn't they like the name Kaziranga Game Sanctuary? Why have they changed it? Who changed? British government changed. So he is asking, why? Why have they changed this one? Didn't they like the name of Kaziranga Game Sanctuary? Actually, now mother is replying, actually, game also means animals hunted for sport and food. Now she is saying, actually the fact is what you know, game sanctuary in the name, no, some problem is there. When we mention the name game, it means what? It means animals hunted for sport and food. Though hunting is strictly prohibited in Kaziranga game sanctuary, but in its name, no, it is there. The word is there. What is the word? Game. And game means what? Hunting of, in game, no, it is included, that hunting of animals for sports or for food. So when in its name the word game is there, then how can we prohibit hunting of animals inside this sanctuary? Okay, that would not be nice, not be a nice name for a park where you want to conserve animals, would it? And now mother is saying, we have, or the government have changed Kaziranga forest to Kaziranga reserve forest, then made it a game sanctuary. Why? To preserve animals. But in name the problem is there. If in name the problem is there, would it be a nice thing to give name to a place where we don't want to kill animals, we don't want to hunt animals, but in name it is there, you can hunt animals. So it is not a nice thing to give name to a place where we want to preserve or protect animals. Okay, and we are that means not aware enough while giving the name. It is not nice. And she is asking, would it, do you think it is nice to give name to a place where we want to protect or preserve animals, but in name it is there, you can hunt animals for food or sport? Would it be a nice thing? No, actually not. So it was renamed Kaziranga Wildlife Sanctuary in 1950 by P.D. Stracey, the forest conservationist of that time. That is why the reason is the place is specified to protect or preserve animals, but in name it is there that you can hunt animals for sport or food. Because of that, Dadan wildlife conservationist, that means forest conservationist, P.D. Stracey, he renamed the Kaziranga game sanctuary as Kaziranga Wildlife Sanctuary in 1950. I hope it is clear. That means in name some problem was there. In name the word game was there, and in the word game it includes hunting of animals for food or sport. But this particular place has been preserved. Why? To protect animals. And the name of the place has been given as game sanctuary. That's why it was not a nice thing. It was a problematic name. Because of that, the forest conservationist of that period, that means the forest conservationist of 1950, P.D. Stracey, he had changed the name of Kaziranga game sanctuary to Kaziranga wildlife sanctuary.
Okay.
It was in 1974 only that Kaziranga was designed as a national park, and it was in 1974 only. Okay, it has become Kaziranga National Park. So earlier in 1904 it was Kaziranga Forest. In 1905 it became Kaziranga Reserve Forest. In 1916 a new name has been given, Kaziranga Game Sanctuary. In 1950 the name has been changed and it was renamed as Kaziranga Wildlife Sanctuary. And in 1974 it changed as what? Kaziranga National Park. And when it has changed as Kaziranga National Park, the design of whole Kaziranga Wildlife Sanctuary has been changed. It was newly designed in 1974 and a new name has been given as Kaziranga National Park. Trisha said, now it would be more interesting to see the park. Now Trisha had come to know a lot about this place, and as usual she was what? Curious about places. After listening to the story, she said, now it would be very interesting to visit the place. Now I have come to know about a lot of things about this particular place, this particular Kaziranga National Park. Now, what happened? It will be more interesting to visit Kaziranga National Park. Who said this? Trisha said. The next morning, they entered the park on elephant back. Okay, the night passed, next morning came, and as planned, they entered into the park on an elephant's back. Okay, I told you in my earlier class that while visiting Kaziranga, no, we are two facilities, one in car or another one, what we had to hire one elephant. Okay, either of these two we had to choose. So they have chosen what? Elephant. Okay, elephant ride. They have now they have entered into the Kaziranga National Park on elephant's back. The grasses were so tall that if they had not been on elephant back, they would probably have got lost. From there, no, they are finding that the grasses in the national park were so long, so tall. And now they are imagining that if they had not taken a ride of elephant, they would have been lost in the tall grasses. The grasses were so tall that if they would not have taken the elephant ride, they would have been lost inside these grasses. But from the huge animal's back, they are able to view the vast expanse of the park. But now what happened? From the back of a huge animal, it has become easier for them to view, to see the vast expanse, that means vast land or vast area of Kaziranga National Park. There were marshes here and there. And from elephant's back, they have seen what? Marshes here and there. Marshes means what? The low land, low wetland, which generally becomes what? Flooded during wet season. Okay, so these are marshes. So whole Kaziranga now becomes flooded during rainy season. But when they were visiting Kaziranga, it was not the season of flood, it was not a rainy season. That's why the whole Kaziranga was not underwater, it was not flooded. Some of the places were there, they have seen, they were like marshes. They were like marshes, no, they were marshes, that means wetlands covered by water. So up to this today, I hope you have understood. If you have any doubt regarding the wordings or any sentence or any fact, okay, here we got a lot of years, names, so many things. If you are confused regarding any of these things, you feel free to call me. My number is there with you, and my request is there that you are to call me between 8 to 10 p.m. at night. With that, I am going to conclude my class. Thank you. Thank you once again.